Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog, and I'm coming with another comic book review of a Venom comic that came out this week. This is issue 164 called The Nativity Part 1. And this is part one of a two-part finale. 164, 165 are the last issues of Venom currently. And then in May, for his 30th anniversary, they're going to reboot with a new creative team and a new number one issue. So this is kind of wrapping up the story that Mike Costa has been building up to, but based on some new information I got from Eddie Brock on Facebook, we may know where this story is going. So I'll get into that in my next episode. But for this one, we're just going to keep it short. We're going to talk about the Nativity, and I'm going to give out the digital code. So boom, right there, if you want a free digital copy of this book, first person to go to that website and put in that code, you will get the digital copy. And I'm sorry if you don't get the code, if you're not fast enough, it's okay. We give these out all the time, so you'll have plenty of chances to win in the future. But definitely go pick this up at your local comic store. If you don't get the code, you got to check it out. It's worth reading, even though I'm not super excited about the idea, because we talked about this a lot on my channel. Every time a writer writes Venom, they seem to only have like three stories they want to tell with him. It's either Eddie Brock gets separated from the suit, or the suit goes on to somebody else, or other people have Venom symbiotes or other suits themselves, or it's the symbiote having a baby, or a symbiote having a baby. So the fact that it's another symbiote having a baby setup story isn't really that interesting to me. The issue, though, itself was interesting. Like, this was neat. Mark Bagley did the artwork, so it looked really good. He got to draw the five symbiotes again in this scene, which is cool. And he, you know, basically Eddie Brock is having these nightmares, but he's finding out that it's not just his nightmares, it's the symbiote's nightmares. And it's the symbiote feeling bad that it's keeping a secret from Eddie. And we had talked about that secret before. I was hoping that it was going to be something like Anne Weying, Eddie's wife, still being alive. And maybe it tricked him somehow or messed with his memories to make him think that she died because it was jealous of how he wanted to get back together with her. And he, in the suit, knew, well, if Eddie and Anne get back together, they're going to want to get rid of me. And so I thought that's what the secret was. That was my theory anyway, but it turns out the secret is that the suit is pregnant again, you know, apparently. And so Eddie's keeps having these nightmares of the suit, from the suit, about, you know, children and offspring and all this other stuff, and it's freaking him out. So he goes out to get some fresh air, and he ends up coming across the Shocker, the Spider-Man villain, and the two of them get into it, and the Shocker actually beats Eddie. And the reason being is because the suit, to protect itself, decides to leave Eddie behind. It, like, as the Sonics are coming at him, the Sonics aren't hurting that much. But then as they, you know, affect the jewels in the jewelry shop that Shocker's robbing, the vibrations from the jewels are causing a disturbance to the symbiote. And so the symbiote is so freaked out that it might die while it's pregnant that it wants to leave Eddie. So it leaves Eddie behind. And Eddie is, like, you know, dealing with the sound of, you know, the Shocker's vibrational waves from his gauntlets. And it knocks Eddie out, and he gets knocked unconscious. And the Shocker runs outside into the street and gets hit by a car anyway and gets stopped and picked up by the police. So when Eddie wakes up, he wakes up from another nightmare where he sees, I think, Anne Weying or someone pushing a baby carriage down the sidewalk. And then inside the baby carriage, there's like a symbiote baby that jumps out at her. And it's just another freak, weird, you know, dream sequence that he has. And he wakes up and the suit's back on him and they're on a rooftop. And he's like, what happened? And the suit's like, yeah, you got knocked out. And he's like, yeah, but I got knocked out because you left me. Like, we could have beat Shocker. He's a nobody. And the suit's like, yeah, I know, but I was trying to protect us. And he's like, what do you mean us? Like, we would have been fine. Like, are you talking about me and you, or are you talking about you and somebody else? And Eddie's starting to piece together what the secret might be based on the dreams and everything. So he's starting to put it together himself. But before he can just come out and say it, Claire Dixon shows up. I think that was her name, Claire Dixon. And she was a character that was in the Carnage series that lasted 16 issues. And she apparently died, actually, in his arms, no less. And they died partners and, you know, turning kind of when Eddie started to, you know, come around and turn to be a good guy again. And so he was like, wait, you died. What's going on? And she's like, yeah, don't you, like, how many people in your life have died and stayed dead? And she's like, didn't you die once? And I'm like, well, that's an interesting comment, because I'm wondering maybe if Anne is still out there. I want her to be out there. I want that story told. I would like Anne Weying to still be alive to some degree, because I didn't think her death was handled that well. And I didn't think post her death was handled that well. And we'll talk about that in an upcoming episode for sure. But in this one, you know, the Claire turns out she is after the symbiote. She's after Eddie. So once she knows he has the costume again, she starts blasting at him. And this, and basically Venom and the suit are bouncing across rooftops trying to get away from her. But unfortunately, they don't make it because the suit is still trying to be a little selfish and protect itself. because it wants to have this baby, and of course it gets stopped, and along with Eddie. So as it's trying to leave Eddie, it actually gets blasted back into Eddie, and then it and Eddie are like hit with flames and energy beams and everything, and Eddie gets knocked out again, but this time with the symbiote incapacitated. And then they bring Eddie in, they put a collar on him that restrains him and the symbiote, and he looks at Claire and says, "What's going on?" Like he wakes up and he's like, "What's going on? What are you doing to me?" And the suit's like, "Don't listen to her, Eddie. Like, don't listen to her." And she's like, "Well, obviously, there's obvious reasons why I captured you. You're a good guy, Eddie. You know, you've proved yourself to me. So I want you to walk away from this clean. But the symbiote, we need to stop it before what's about to happen happens." And he says, "What's about to happen?" And the suit's like, "All right, Eddie, I'm gonna confess. I should have told you." And Eddie's like, "Told me what?" And then, you know, that's when Miss Dixon says, "The suit's pregnant, and you're gonna be a daddy." And so, right at the end there, boom, just came out and said it. So clearly, that's the storyline that we're gonna get here, is that it's gonna be another baby. But then, what I found interesting is this time I actually read the letters column, and the editor of the book, Devin Lewis, had mentioned, you know, what does this mean for Venom, for both Eddie and the symbiote? Can anything be done to prevent this new life form from taking after Carnage or Scream or so many other symbiotes, spawns that led a life of villainy? Or is this even a symbiote at all? And that line I found to be interesting, because if it's not a symbiote that it's giving birth to, that actually is a new spin on that story. It's taking that trope but putting a new spin on it. And if that's the case, then I will put my foot in my mouth and give full credit to these guys for not just regurgitating stuff that's come before, but actually trying to put a new spin on it. So I found that line to be very interesting in the letters column. But you know, until we know for sure, I'm still kind of middle of the road of this book. But this is just part one, so we'll learn more in part two. Comes out in about 2 weeks. So when it comes out, I'll pick it up, I'll review it for you guys, we'll give out the digital code, and we'll talk about that. But then we're also going to talk about in the next episode, and I'll set it up here, something that I saw on Eddie Brock's Facebook page, one of our friends, Eddie Brock. So on that video, we'll link to his Facebook page and stuff, and we'll also put a link to the Amazon page. But there is a graphic novel coming out in December of this year, listed on Amazon, that Eddie Brock saw, and he said, "Ooh, interesting. Like, what could this be?" And it's written by Mike Costa, and it's drawn by Mark Bagley, and it's called Venom: First Host. And considering it's not coming out to December, must mean it's a new maybe series or mini series that's going to start probably like this summer at some point. And it'll be separate from the main Venom book. And I'm guessing that what they're setting up here with the other child, that's going to be something that Mike Costa and Mark Bagley, they pay off in their other, because I mentioned that a couple episodes ago, that I was like, I don't know if Donny Cates is going to be, or the new writer on Venom, I don't know if he's going to be the one who's going to, like, you know, deal with this offspring, or if Mike Costa is going to come back and tell a story later this fall, because Marvel's already hinted that there will be a Venom event this fall. I'm guessing that's what this is. So Nativity may be a lot more important than just ending this series and setting up the next series. This may actually be something that is going to pay off in a separate book, another second Venom monthly title called First Host. Or maybe that's just the name of the first arc of the story. I don't know. But we're going to talk about First Host in the next episode. So yeah, we'll kind of speculate there. So let me know what you guys think of this issue. Did you pick it up yourself? If you did you like it? Did you not like it? Let me know down in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching my channel. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the future. Peace.